In this video, I will talk about binding and non-binding constraints in linear programming problems. A constraint is binding if the left-hand side and right-hand side of the constraint are equal at the optimal solution. Otherwise, it's non-binding. Let's check this example. It has two constraints, C1 and C2, and two sign restrictions, S3 and S4. Using the graphic method, we can find that the slope of the objective function is negative 3. If we move the line towards the top right corner, this is the last point before leaving the feasible region. So it is the optimal solution. x1 is equal to 4.5 and x2 is equal to 0. Let's plug these values into the constraints and sign restrictions. For C1, we have 2 times 4.5 plus 0 is equal to 9, which is equal to the right-hand side. So C1 is binding. For C2, we have 4.5 plus 2 times 0 is equal to 4.5, which is less than the right-hand side. So C2 is non-binding. For S3, we have 4.5 is greater than 0, which is the right-hand side. So S3 is non-binding. For S4, we have 0 is equal to 0, which is the right-hand side. So S4 is binding. We can also tell whether a constraint is binding or not directly from this figure. If the optimal solution is on the constraint line, then it's binding. The optimal point is on C1 and S4, so they are binding. The other two constraints are non-binding. Okay, these are the concepts of binding and non-binding constraints. Thanks for watching.